A blessed morning, dear brothers and sisters in Christ. Welcome to Carmelite Monastery. We are now on the 18th Sunday in Ordinary Time. God's concern for people's earthly needs is manifested when Jesus multiplies the bread and fish and feeds the crowd that has followed him. But when the Jews focus on the physical bread and fail to realize the importance of Jesus' presence among them, they fall short of discovering the many surprises God has in store for them. We also celebrate today St. John Baptist Marie Vianney Sunday, the patron of priests. We remember in this Mass all our priests, that they may continue to be living witnesses of Jesus, the bread of life. Let us now rise and welcome our Lord Jesus Christ in the person of his minister, Reverend Father Roy Christian Gisulgon.
In the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brethren, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess, Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and my words, in what I have done, what I have failed to do. Through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace.
us pray. Draw near to your servants, O Lord, and answer their prayers with unceasing kindness, that for those who glory in you as their creator and guide, you may restore what you have created and keep safe what you have restored. The Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. The Israelites grumble against Moses and Aaron. In response, the Lord sends them manna. This story prepares us for the gospel, where the people are intrigued when Jesus tells them that he can give something better than the manna in the desert. The first reading.
A reading from the book of Exodus. The whole Israelite community grumbled against Moses and Aaron. The Israelites said to them, "Would that we had died at the Lord's hand in the land of Egypt, as we sat by flesh pots and ate our fill of bread. But you had to lead us into this desert to make the whole community die of famine." Then the Lord said to Moses, "I will now rain down bread from heaven for you. Each day, the people are going to go out and gather their daily portion. Thus, will I test them to see whether they follow my instructions or not. I have heard the grumbling of the Israelites. Tell them, in the evening twilight, you shall eat flesh, and in the morning, you shall have your fill of bread, so that you may know that I, the Lord, am your God. In the evening, quail came up and covered the camp. In the morning, a dew lay all about the camp. And when the dew evaporated, there on the surface of the desert were fine flakes like hoar frosts on the ground. On seeing it, the Israelites asked one another, 'What is this?' For they did not know what it was. But Moses told them, 'This is the bread that the Lord has given you to eat.'" The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
The Apostle Paul tells his converts that they have become new persons in Christ. As such, they should not stick to their former lives as pagans, but acquire a new way of thinking and living as befits their new dignity. The second reading.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Sisters and brothers, I declare and testify in the Lord that you must no longer live as the Gentiles do, in the futility of their minds. That is not how you learned Christ, assuming that you have heard of him and were taught in him, as truth is in Jesus, that you should put away the old self of your former way of life, corrupted through deceitful desires, and be renewed in the spirit of your minds, and put on a new self, created in God's way in righteousness and holiness of truth. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Please all rise.
One does not live on bread alone, but for every word that comes forth from the mouth of God.
Be with you.
And with your spirit.
Proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to St. John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When the crowd saw that neither Jesus nor his disciples were there, they themselves got into boats and came to Capernaum looking for Jesus. And when they found him across the sea, they said to him, Rabbi, when did you get here? Jesus answered them and said, Amen, amen, I say to you, you are looking for me not because you saw signs, but because you ate the loaves and were filled. Do not work for food that perishes, but for food that endures for eternal life, which the Son of Man will give you. For on him, the Father, God has set his seal. So they said to him, What can we do to accomplish the works of God? Jesus answered and said to them, This is the work of God, that you believe in the one he sent. So they said to him, What sign can you do that we may see and believe in you? What can you do? Our ancestors ate manna in the desert, as it is written, He gave them bread from heaven to eat. So Jesus said to them, Amen, amen, I say to you, It was not Moses who gave the bread from heaven. My Father gives you the true bread from heaven. For the bread of God is that which comes down from heaven and gives life to the world. So they said to him, Sir, give us this bread always. Jesus said to them, I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me will never hunger, and whoever believes in me will never thirst. Friends, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Good morning, my dear brothers and sisters in Christ. We are on the 18th Sunday in Ordinary Time, and this is also St. John Marie Vianney Sunday. And so we offer this Mass as we remember all our priests, especially those who have been part of our lives. That is the beauty of the priesthood and the sacraments. They accompany us from womb to tomb, you know?
mga pari nga nagbunyag sa aton, mga pari nga nagpakumpisar, nagpakalawat, nagkasal, asa nga naglubong sa mga pinalangga naton sa kabuhi. And so we thank the Lord for the gift of priesthood, and so we pray for all priests for today, St. John Marie Vianney Sunday. My dear friends, our gospel for today and practically the readings focus on the theme of the signs. What are signs? They are symbols, and they are those that point to realities other than themselves. So if you have a sign, it points to a reality other than itself. And a couple of days, we have been jubilant as a country because we've got our first gold in the Olympics. No? Heidelin Diaz came victorious after lifting 120-something, no? Set for us a record in the Olympics. And in that sense, we can also consider Heidelin to be a sign. The gold medal becomes a sign because it points to something other than itself. It is symbolic of the aspirations of Filipinos of being also people capable of greatness. It points to the aspiration of a people who has been for quite some time unbelieving of their capacity also to be good and better. Sa sobra mo kung isa bala ka tulok lang sang duta, no? Sa sobra mo nga tulok sang duta, galakat ka doga, sikad ka na lang, daga sipa sang lata, no? Nado ay, do wala na gid ni, do wala na gid kaayuhan. Then one day comes a sign that you're also capable of something good, that there's still something that is hopeful among Filipinos. You have Heidelin Diaz, a sign of the aspiration of a downtrodden, in a sense, desperate people for a model for greatness. But is what the victory of Diaz was not achieved overnight. It was also a product of hard work. But not simply her work, but also of a power greater than her. And so we also celebrate the gift of faith of the Filipinos. What a grace-filled experience to have a gold medal as the Philippines also celebrates 500 years of Christianity, as Heidelin Diaz also gives witness to her faith. No? A very Marian faith. Kanami, hindi lang gold nga medalya ang ibutang sa iyang liog, kundi before the gold medal was the miraculous medal of Our Lady, a fitting witness to a faith that has become part of the life of the Filipino. Beautiful. So our human aspiration in that sense also needs a power beyond us for us fully to achieve things, and that power is the power of God. The power of faith. A sign is something that points to a reality other than itself. And here in the gospel for today, we are given the ultimate sign, the sign of God's caring presence, the sign of a God who always hears the cries of his people. In the Old Testament, our first reading, we heard the story of Moses and the grumblings of the people of Israel. Indala mo kami, di anok mo kami, pagutman, ng mga reklamo. Di ka damo, manta sa mga reklamo, hindi bala, nami na. Now, the sign is that we are like also those people. Pala reklamo. And here comes a counter sign for the grumblings of the people. A man of faith, Moses. And Moses appeals to God. And Moses sends quails in the evening and manna in the morning. God sends, as an answer to the grumblings of the people, quails in the evening and manna in the morning. Beautiful. And the quails and the manna are actually signs from the Lord. I like the detail that is preserved for us from the book of Exodus as to the purpose of that sign. And what is the purpose of that sign? So that they will know that I, the Lord, am your God. Beautiful. A sign is something that points to a reality other than itself. That when we experience the manna, when we eat the quails, when we feast on it, we experience a reality other than the food. Food represents God's providence. And as such, the food becomes a sign. Kanami. And the same is true with our gospel for today. Jesus has performed numerous signs before people, but only to be dismayed in a sense that people didn't recognize the signs. Gapangayo pa sila sign. Ara nagid sa ila tubangan ang ultimate sign. A God who walks with us. A God who provides for us. A God who is willing to dwell with His people. Jesus as the ultimate sign of the Father. And here He performs deeds that are supposed to remind people of this kind of a God. Kasi nalipat ka mo, ginpakaon ka mo sang Diyos while you were in the desert. Subong inang Diyos, wala man naglain, ginapakaon makamugyapon. But this time, it is a God who will satisfy all your longings. And Jesus was very clear about it. I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me will never hunger, and whoever believes in me will never thirst. Our gospel is from the gospel of John. And in the gospel of John, we have so many signs performed by Jesus. His first sign, the wedding at Cana. He turned water into wine. Beautiful. There is also the healing of the official's son. There is also the healing at the pool of Bethesda. The feeding of the 5,000. The walking on water by Jesus, the healing of a man born blind, and lastly, the resurrection of Lazarus. These were the signs performed by Jesus. So many signs, yet people are unable to recognize the signs. Tika nami. Sa ato kabuhi, siguro mo makita sina. Kada mo nakihimo ang Diyos nga sign sa ato natubangan, pero wala pa tayo ka mulalong sa mga signs, kag meaning sa mga signs. When I was a young priest, I was assigned to Silay as parochial vicar. Once I was invited to an area mass, no? And before I celebrated the mass, because it was a fiesta, the kapilyan already told me, no may ano na dayon disclaimer no mga ba, father wala lang tahanda subong kay pigado gid diba. During the mass I was delivering the homily, then there's this chicken gatagan-lagan sa kapilyang manok. Disiling ko ara na hindi niyo pa na makilala ang sign huwag tayong handa o ang Diyos nagpadala sa manok. Di pala nagpadala sa quail, sa doong chimpo. Subong kay Philippinized quail, manok. Manok native. Para butangan context. Amo niyang Filipino context. Why quail, manok. Tapos siling ko ara, dakpa ang manok, iyawon ta, kay mapapiesta kita. The inability to recognize the signs. Oh, Ara na, in front of our noses, God has been performing signs since day one, yet we are unable to decipher and recognize the signs. The same is true with this incident in the gospel. Before them is a God who walks with them, a God who cares for them, the Son of God, Jesus himself. But they were unable to recognize him. Why? Because most of the time, we have been looking for other signs that fit our standards and expectations. Na amod lang niyang gusto ko, Lord, dapat blugid siya. Dapat 25 kilograms. May mga standard kay Imo ya. Naghatag na siya galing yellow. Naghatag na siya galing 30 kilograms. Gusto mo ginipilit ang 25 kilograms. Inability to see the signs because you have your own expectation, your own definition of what that sign is. My dear friends, as we celebrate also St. John Marie Vianney Sunday, we thank the Lord for the sign of ministry. The Jesus who walked with his people, the Jesus who fed the multitude, is in the here and now, is also to be seen and experienced in the ministries of the church. We thank the Lord for the gift of priesthood. But at the same time, we recognize that as baptized Christians, we are also to partake of the same priesthood of Christ. Jesus as priest, who is not simply one who ministers, but also became even more the offering himself, the victim. Amo na yung priesthood ni Jesus. Hindi separate ang minister kag ang offering. The offering and the victim or the minister is one and the same. The one who offers is also the one to be offered. And that is the life of service. That is the life of ministry in the church. We share in the priesthood of Christ as baptized. In my case, I share in the ministerial priesthood. In your case, you share in the royal or the common priesthood of the baptized. I would like to anchor that on the document of the church, Vatican II document now, Lumen Gentium, number 10. The common priesthood of the faithful and the ministerial or hierarchical priesthood are nonetheless interrelated. Each of them, in its own special way, is a participation in the one priesthood of Christ. The ministerial priest, by the sacred power he enjoys, teaches and rules the priestly people, acting in the person of Christ. He makes present the Eucharist, sacrifice, and offer it to God in the name of all the people. And take note of your share in this priesthood. Lumen Gentium 10 continues, but the faithful, in virtue of their royal priesthood, join in the offering of the Eucharist. They likewise exercise that priesthood in receiving the sacraments, in prayer, and in thanksgiving, in witness of a holy life, and by self-denial and active charity. Beautiful. The priesthood of Jesus giving bread to people is likewise to be experienced by lay people when they give themselves in a holy life and acts of charity. So technically, hindi lang kami ang pari who share in the priesthood of Jesus. You also share in the priesthood of Christ, in ministries, in service. Tikanami, you also give of yourself. As parents, when you sacrifice for your children, when you pray for people in need, you also exercise your common priesthood. Last story, when I was admitted at the hospital for COVID-19, I stayed in an isolation facility, isolation room there, and Simply, I was thinking, God has allowed me to be ministered to by people of goodwill. And that was a very humbling and beautiful experience, an experience of the interrelatedness between the ministerial priesthood and the common priesthood of the laity. As priests, we are used to be the ones ministering to people. And now God has allowed me to be ministered to by lay people, doctors, nurses, janitors, who are exercising their own participation in the priesthood of Christ. In that sense, when you pray, when you serve people, you're also acting out your participation of Christ's priesthood. In that sense, you are also invited to become a sign of Jesus for the world. My dear friends, we thank the Lord for the gift of this Sunday as we give testimony to our faith. We thank the Lord for the gift of ministry, the gift of priesthood that you also share as lay people by virtue of your baptism. We thank the Lord and ask Him for the grace. Lord, allow us also to be like bread so that we can feed the hunger of this world by works of charity, by works of ministry. Saint John Marie Vianney, pray for us. Amen. Let us now rise and profess our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible. I believe in the one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us men and for our salvation. He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead, the life of the world to come. Amen. Father, you satisfy the hungry with loaves and fishes through your Son Jesus. Help us become more and more like your Son as we pray. Lord, fill us with your love.
Lord, fill us with your love.
Let the service rendered by those who lead the church serve us food that brings life and nourishment to the needy. We pray.
Lord, fill us with your love.
That government leaders and other public servants may implement and promote policies that answer the basic needs of the people whom they serve. We pray.
Lord, fill us with your love.
That those who are sick, lonely, anxious, and depressed may find strength and healing in Jesus, the bread of life. We pray.
Lord, fill us with your love.
That those who have gone ahead of us may know the fullness of salvation in Christ Jesus, and celebrate God's love forever. We pray.
Lord, fill us with your love. Let us also pray for our sick and elderly priest at Domus Dei. We also pray for new vocations to the priesthood. We pray for our seminarians at Sacred Heart Seminary. We pray.
Lord, fill us with your love.
God, our Father, we ask you to transform our lives so that, like yours, our words and actions may nourish and give life to our brothers and sisters. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please all rise.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Be pleased, O Lord, to accept the offerings of your church, for in your mercy you have given them to be offered, and by your prayer or by your power you transformed them into the mystery of our salvation, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for we know it belongs to your boundless glory that you came to the aid of mortal beings with your divinity, and even fashioned for us a remedy out of mortality itself, that the cause of our downfall might become the means of our salvation, through Christ our Lord. Through him the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like a dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, giving thanks, broke it, and he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world. Save us, Savior of the world. For by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Patricio, our Bishop, Vicente, Bishop Emeritus, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. All who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Our Lady of Mount Carmel, with Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints, Saint Sebastian, Saint Lorenzo Ruiz, Saint Pedro Calungsod, Saint Teresa of Avila, Saint Teresa of the Child Jesus, Saint John of the Cross, all the saints who please you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, we praise and glorify you, your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. For the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we now call upon God, our Father. Lord, we pray from every evil and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace, I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will. Live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace. Friends, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
The body of Christ.
Amen. We shall have our second collection in support of the ongoing formation of our clergy. Thank you.
Oh.
Please all rise.
Let us pray. Accompany with constant protection, O Lord, those you renew with these heavenly gifts, and in your never-failing care for them, make them worthy of eternal redemption. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please all kneel for the mission prayer. God, our loving Father, you sent your Son into the world to proclaim the good news of salvation to all, to sinners, the poor, oppressed, the sick, the abandoned and neglected. He gave his life on the cross for us and rose again to new life, to redeem us and reconcile us with you. You sent your Holy Spirit to the apostles to continue the work of your Son and to lead all to salvation. We thank you, Father, for bringing us from darkness into light through your loving plan. 500 years ago, missionaries came to our land to proclaim the gospel of Jesus, your Son, to our ancestors that made us your people and the church. The gift of faith has accompanied us through both darkness and light, defeats and victories of our history as your people. Our faith has become for us true light that shines in the darkness. Renew in us the grace of your Spirit that impels us to be witnesses of Jesus, your Son, to a world broken by greed, violence, injustice, sickness, and suffering. May our faith bring us to unity as your children, to care for and love one another. May the Holy Spirit empower us to be proclaimers of the good news to our brothers and sisters in Asia and to all nations. Give us the sincere desire to help others to come to faith in the Lord Jesus, to share in your joy and life. May the Blessed Mother, the star of evangelization, accompany us and pray for us as we live and share our faith with others. May our strong love and devotion to her as our Mahal na Ina form us to be true disciples and witnesses of Jesus to all, always ready to be sent and to be obedient to whatever Jesus asks of us. We ask this through Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. Please all rise.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you and your loved ones, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Eucharist has been offered. Let us go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.